Hello and welcome to the UBO Garage. Today I'm going to show you the basics of wiring a Phoenix Storm Pro siren. I have here both a 100 watt, 200 watt, as well as a Triton 100 watt speaker. The first ports you'll have are your power and your ground. Really simple, that's where you apply your power and your ground to the siren. After that, you'll have your tone speakers. On a 200 watt, you're going to notice you have twice as many. This is because a 200 watt can handle two speakers, while a 100 watt can only handle one speaker. On a 200 watt, you can program different tones to each of the tone ports. The same for the 100 watt. After that, on the 200 watt, your next port will be a dual delay. This is if you want to give the illusion, while using two speakers, that two vehicles are approaching. You can set two tones and activate the dual delay. After that, you'll have the horn ring. The horn ring allows you to connect your vehicle's horn to activate the storm. After that is park kill. You can connect this to your vehicle, and once you put your vehicle into park, it'll turn the storm off. Next is broadcast on and radio in. These can be connected to your radio and broadcast over the speaker what's being played through your radio. After that will be your speaker ports. On the 100 watt, there's two ports for one speaker. On the 200 watt, there's four ports for two speakers. Notice that two of them are yellow and two of them are red. The yellow coincides with the yellow tone ports, while the red coincides with the red tone ports. On the side, you'll have an RJ45 port. This is if you want to connect to the Phoenix 4200. By connecting with a data link cable, you won't need to activate any of these extra ports. Everything will be done through the data link transmission. Next, you have your port for the microphone. The microphone activates as soon as you press the button on the side of the mic. Also on the side is your tone changing port. Let me show you how that works. I have a jumper wire here, as well as a small speaker, so that we don't lose our hearing. Once I activate them, I can press the tone changing port and scroll through all the tones. Once I find a tone that I like, I just leave it. And now every time I hit that switch and activate that port, it'll turn that siren back on. The same can be done for any of the tones, and you can set any siren tone you want to each one of those ports. So that's the basics of wiring your Storm Pro siren. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.